Hey guys, welcome back to Streaming Nerds, and today I have a very important video tutorial for you guys. So today I'm going to show you how you can stop the apps that are running in the background on your Android box. And guys, before I go ahead, if you think that I'm creating useful tutorials for you guys, please hit the like button on this video and also do not forget to subscribe to my channel. You can subscribe by scrolling down a little bit and then hitting that red subscribe button. So let's get right into the tutorial. Well, a lot of users message me that their Android box is slow or their Android box is laggy. And some users also report that sometimes when they open an app like Kodi, it just closes back. Or it opens up and then after a few minutes, it closes back. And guys, it is very possible that these errors are due to a lot of apps running in the background. So today in this video, I'm going to show you how we can stop those apps from running in the background. And I know a lot of Android box users are not sure how they can close the apps that are running in the background. Well, there are lots of Android boxes and they can have different interfaces, but the procedure will remain the same for all the Android boxes out there. Well, in this tutorial, I'll be using an Android box and I will be also using an RII8 remote. And then after that, I will also be using an IR remote, an infrared remote. So you can see both of these remotes on the screen right now. And these are the most widely used remotes by Android box users. So let's get on to the first part of our tutorial. That is how to stop the apps that are running in the background of your Android box with the RII8 remote. So you can see right now I'm on the main screen of my Android box. So this is the first thing that you need to do. You need to be on the main screen of your Android box. So once you're on the main screen, what you need to do is on your RII8 remote, you need to press the Alt button, which you can find towards the bottom of the keypad. You need to press the Alt button and keep it pressed. And then you need to press the Tab button once. You can see on the screen right now, I have marked the Alt button and the Tab button in green squares. And you can see I have also marked the trackpad area because we're going to use the trackpad area later on. And I have marked the trackpad area in red. So what you need to do is you need to press the Alt button on your RII8 remote and then you need to press the Tab button once. I have pressed the Alt button and now I'm going to press the Tab button once. And you can see it brings up the apps that are running in the background. So all these apps are running in the background and now I will use the trackpad area of my keypad and I'm going to drag finger on the trackpad area and you can see I'm dragging my finger and I am taking the pointer to the cross area at the top right corner. You can see there is the cross at the top right and I'm going to tap on my trackpad. So you can see I tapped on my trackpad and it closed that window. So that background app has been closed and now I'm going to close this one also, which is ES File Explorer, taking my pointer to the cross, tapping on the trackpad and there you go. And then again, I will hit the track and then again, I'm going to tap on the trackpad because my pointer is on the cross and it is closed. And then I have Kodi, I will just close it as well, hitting on the trackpad. The settings page is also closed. So you can see we're back automatically to the main screen of our Android box because I have closed all the apps that we're running in the background. So the memory that was being used by all these apps that we're running in the background, that memory is free now. And that memory is available to the box. So if we go ahead and open a new app or if we try to watch a movie, it will be smooth because we have enough memory for the other programs to work properly. So that's how you can close the apps that are running in the background with an RII8 remote. And guys, now I will show you how we can stop the background apps with the default IR remote. So you can see right now I'm showing you the default IR remotes and how they look. So these are the two default remotes that come with almost all the Android boxes. So right now you can see I'm on the main screen of my Android device and on my default IR remote, I'm going to use the up and down arrow keys to navigate and I'm going to press the down arrow key here and I will try to go onto the bar that is located at the bottom of my box. I'm trying to go there and you can see it has the selection has gone there and now I will go into my apps from the circle with six stars. I have selected it pressing OK on my remote. And now you can see I'm inside my apps and in here I will try to go on to settings. So let me try to go down and you can see right here I have settings And guys, right now I'm trying to use the default IR remote and bring my selection to the settings, but I'm unable to do it with the up and down arrow keys, left and right arrow keys. I'm unable to do it with those keys. So what you will need to do is you will need to press the cursor button. And right now on the screen, you can see I have marked the cursor button in green. You need to press this once and then press the down arrow key once. So I have pressed the cursor key once, and now I'm going to press the down arrow key once. And you can see that the cursor has popped up on the screen. And I'm going to use the up and down arrow keys to take my pointer to the settings. So I'm using the left arrow key to take it to the left side. And I'm near to settings. And now I will take it a little bit up. Okay, we're on settings, and now I'm going to press OK on my remote. And now it takes us inside the Android settings. And in here, what I need to do is I will need to take my pointer. So I'm trying to drag my pointer to the right side. Take your pointer to the right side and then take it a little bit down to the more settings option in here. And this is the more settings option. I have taken my pointer there, and now I'm going to press OK on my remote. Okay, I have tried to press OK, but it went a little bit up. So let me try to take the pointer up. Okay, again, on to my more settings option, pressing OK on my default IR remote, pressing OK. And now it has taken us to the core Android settings. And in here, you need to go on to apps. And I will take my cursor to the left side first. And now I will take it a little bit down. And you can see apps is right here. And I've taken my cursor on apps, and I will press OK on my remote. And now you can see we are inside our apps. And right now you can see we are inside the downloaded section, but we don't want to be inside the downloaded section. We have to go on the running section. And you can see right now we are inside the downloaded section, but I will take my cursor to the right side. It takes a little while with the default IR remote, but yes, you can do it. And we are on the, and I have taken my cursor to the running option, pressing OK on my remote. And now we're inside the running section where all the running applications are being shown up. So you can see at the top right corner, we have an option which is show cached processes. We need to click on this one so that it can show us the apps that are running in the background. So I have taken my pointer here, and I'm going to press OK on my remote. And now it displays all the apps that are running in the background. So you can see let me go a little bit down and let me show you what kind of apps are running on the device. So I'm trying to go a little bit down, but this cursor is not letting me. So I will turn off the cursor by pressing the cursor button again on my remote. So I will press the cursor button again on my remote, and you can see the cursor button has gone, and you can see the pointer has gone from the screen. And now I will just try to scroll down a little bit, and you can see my selection is going down. And you can see we have Chrome, we have Super SU, and we have this browser. We don't need these apps in the background to take up our memory, so we're going to stop these apps. So what we'll do is, for example, if we don't need the Chrome browser to run in the background, we'll press OK on it. And then it brings up this page. And in here, you can see there is only one option, which is stop. So we'll press OK on our default IR remotes. I'm pressing OK. And now you can see the Chrome browser is gone. And likewise for Super SU here, if we don't want it to run in the background, we're going to press OK on this one. And it again brings up this page. And now we'll again press OK on our remote, and it will stop it. And now you can see that Super SU is also gone. And similarly for other apps as well, if you don't want them running on the background, you can come in here and stop all the apps that are not needed to run in the background. So now we have stopped the applications that we are running in the background. So I'm going back to the home screen by pressing the home button on my remote. So guys, I must say mission accomplished. I must say mission accomplished, because it is a little bit difficult with the default IR remote. But yes, you can do it. But guys, I will highly recommend you to get an RII8 remote, and I'm sure you will never regret it. In fact, you are going to love it so much that you will forget the default IR remote. And if you want to order your RII8 remote, check the description of this video and you will find a link which will take you to the page where you can order RII8 remote. So guys, that's it for this video, and we highly recommend using a VPN if you're streaming content. And to get started with our highly recommended VPN, click on the lock icon that you can see to the top left corner of this video. Click on that lock icon and get started with our highly recommended VPN. And guys, I'll be back with more awesome videos, so stay tuned to my channel, and I love you all. Bye bye.